Hi, YouTubers. I'm glad you're here with me. Today is January 1st, 2023, and I hope everyone has a blessed new year that is coming. Recently, there was a magnitude 5.5 earthquake there by Rio Dell, Northern California. USGS said it was a 5.4, but let me bring it down for you. It was actually a magnitude 5.5. 294 earthquakes. This area is capable of having a large earthquake, a magnitude 8 or greater. A lot of earthquakes ever since they had that magnitude 6.4 about a week ago. Reports are still coming in. The number of people that have reported it to USGS is 1,104, and they gave it an intensity level of 7, which means everyone runs outdoors. There was reports of people getting in doorways. You have to be careful when you go in doorways, because if it's got a door there, the door could swing and cut off or break your fingers. Damage to buildings varies depending on the quality of construction noticed by drivers of automobiles. There was 2 YouTube or Twitter videos during the earthquake, and they got a lot of flooding going on because of the heavy rains that Northern California is getting. Yeah, landslides, all kinds of trouble. Looks like it was felt as far north in Oregon in the Willamette Valley and as far south as probably Monterey, San Jose, San Francisco. No, we got one farther. We got Bakersfield and Anaheim, down there by Los Angeles. This was a reverse or oblique thrust earthquake. This often happens in areas of where continents collide. And I've talked about this area, how we got the North American plate moving west. We got the Cascadia subduction zone, going east. And normally you have a hanging wall, one side that is stuck, that will rise up, and the other side doesn't move, which means more tension is applied. They changed the moment tensor ball here. What they're showing now is actually a bit of spreading, but you can see the X marks a spot right in the middle, just about. Probably the west side, the east side is what rose up, because it looks like it moved a little bit slightly going west and dipping down. So the east side is what rose up and got stuck. I'll give you a link down below on this paper and the other documents that I'll show you. But an oblique thrust earthquake is where the fault actually moves, but one side rises up. These are often very devastating large earthquakes. Also here on seismo.berkeley.ed, they have about these oblique events. Oblique events can be a mixture of both strike slip and a dip slip, meaning that the fault blocks are moving both horizontally and vertically with respect to each other's. So here is the location of that earthquake. Now picture the plate moving west, and compression is built up. We also have here a fault line. Do I have the name of it written out? I don't see a name for this fault line, but more than likely it extends going towards the east. And this is the area where USGS said it occurred. We got homes. Let me show you some of the felt reports. First, I want to show you here. This was Fortuna, 33 kilometers northeast. So that would be about 25 miles. It says here, I agree with the other person from Fortuna that this one was stronger than last week, 6.4. Just not as long. And we heard the freight train coming fast right before it hit. Yep, I hate these damn things. while the other one was off the coast. Here's the one about the doorway. I went to the doorway, knocked a couple of small things off the shelves, and had a few things slide around. No actual damage that we have seen other than our stress levels. And that one also came from Fortuna. Another one says it was a good jolt. At end of shaking, things fell. Woke me up. Yeah, they were still sleeping. Well, they were probably up last night for the New Year's. A couple of things broke. All right, and what else do we got here? A good jolt. In church, rocked and rolled. That was in Eureka. Sacramento. Well, it says Sacramento, but they got listed Eureka. Oh, here from Sacramento to help with the local assistance center in Rio Dell. Just a mild jolt, then some rolling for a few seconds. Nice way to say goodbye when I'm about to hit the road home. Hope everyone is safe. Really slammed and shook our house in Cutton, California. Heard the house squeaking and a few moderate shakes and light rolling. That was also Eureka. Okay, about 10 second shake. Creaking of the house. Hanging lamp swayed a little. One interior door opened. Nothing fell. Felt in Manila. I don't think they did. Was strong, but very short. Nothing broke. Just a lot of movement. They don't have anything listed here. Very quick rattle, the house, but no damage. Storm shaking, no damage. Rolling. Yeah, they're getting slammed with the flooding right now. Long rolling, no quick jarring movement, excuse me. Light and short jolt, nothing too crazy. That was in Arcadia. Now, this says Blue Lake. I wonder if it's Blue Lakes there in Lake County. More gentle than the 6, but definitely decent shaker. And it seemed to last and be a bit more drawn out. Visible shaking. McKinleyville. Okay. Shaking, rattling windows. McKinleyville. Yep, felt that one. Dogs responded by walking off, and one barked. Hanging things were swaying. Shelved objects were chattering and clanking a bit. This one said they didn't feel it in Fort Bragg. Clear Lake Oaks. See, this is Lake County. It felt like a pretty strong shake, rolling motion at first. East towards west. Yeah, see, if the plates are moving from east to west, and then just kind of rolling itself out. Yeah, that's what I said is going on with the plates, the North American plate, going from east to west. Yeah, just think of that. If the Cascadia Fault decides to rupture, are you prepared? Everything west of the interstate is going to be toast. Yeah, it just shows you that more tension has built up. This thing is not done. Now, this monitor comes from a borehole. All right, got interrupted, sorry. My daughter called. We're supposed to get 4 to 10 inches of snow starting tomorrow. Wanted to know if I need anything from the store. Thought that was very thankful. Very thoughtful of her. Anyways, okay, we got another earthquake here at 10:34 Universal Time. So that would be at 2:33 about. They're saying it's a magnitude 2. Oh, they're not reporting it. Okay. I had to go back and look and see what that. I thought they were saying it was a 2.7 something. So we'll see how big that one was. And go about there. 2.3. Maybe I did see it and I just missed it again. So that's a magnitude 2.38. There it is. Okay, I did see it. Okay, they're saying it's a 2.4. But they must have made a longer seismic wave. Took that into account. Close to Rio Dell. So I hope everyone is prepared for a larger earthquake. Like I said, it is overdue for a large earthquake. Get that stuff away from your beds and your chairs and bolt the stuff to the walls. Have bottled water. And as you experience with the 6.4, don't count on medical people to arrive. The Fern Bridge, once again, there in Humboldt County is closed. They're doing safety inspections on it. And I was looking at this image here. I don't know if I can make it bigger. Yeah, it's got a good image of it. But there was other bridges, too, that were closed and being inspected. Yeah, the guardrails look okay. But anyways, yeah, be prepared. Do what you can. Don't be lazy. And I want to thank you all for watching, and I want to thank everyone for your support. Yeah, we all pray that 2023 is going to be better than the last 2 years. But as always, prepare for the worst and pray for the best. Thank you again for watching, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all.